there. Welcome to another video in the Scriptcase Macros course. Today we're looking at two macros, the SE Select Field Macro and the SE Label Macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's go ahead and look at what these macros do. SE Select Field dynamically substitutes one field in the application select for another field. So these are two fields that are in the database table, but you can switch them out dynamically. SE Label then changes the field's label. So we're going to use this after we swap out the fields to change the label of the field. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation here. So let me go over to the documentation and let me find SE Select Field first. So SE Select Field right there. Let me click on it. So this field, this macro, we just pass through the field. And we tell it the field that we want it to switch to. So here's an option using a global variable. And then here's changing the label as well. So let's go ahead and look at SE Label to see how this works. So let's go back up to the top of macros here and find SE Label. That's going to be down in the control section here. So there it is, SE Label. And this is pretty simple. We just passed through the field that we want to change the label of, and then pass through the value that we want for the label. So pretty simple. Let's go ahead and go back to the SE select field, because we're going to copy that example right there. That's going to be pretty simple. And so, let's go over to Scriptcase and see how this is done. So we have a grid here, just a basic grid with a few fields. So I have three fields, actor ID, first name, and last name. We're going to swap out actor ID right here for another field in this table called last update. So let's go ahead and run this so you can see it. So there is our actor ID field that we're going to swap out with last update, which is a date time field. So let's go ahead and copy this example from the documentation. And let's put this in one of the events. We're going to put this in the on script init event. This needs to be processed before the select. So as you can see, right here, this needs to be in an on init. This is before the select for that grid is processed so that we can actually swap it out. After that is going to be too late. So we're going to do this for the actor ID field. So there it is, actor underscore ID. So we pass through the field we want to swap out. And this is going to be the new field. So last underscore update is the name of that field. This is in the database table, same table. We're just not selecting it initially. So now when we run this, it should swap out that data. We should see date time values instead of these integer values. So let's go ahead and run this. And there we go. So now we have date time values instead of the integer values. So it did swap out the data. So it's selecting a different field. So now we need to change the label. So let's go back to the documentation here and let's copy this line for the label, the SE label. So this is our second macro that we're talking about in this video. And so now we need to swap it out. The actor ID field is now going to have a new label. And we're just going to call that last update now. So last update, no underscores. So there it looks nice for the user. Let's go ahead and run this. And now it should have a new label as well as new data. So there we go. Last update with a date time value. So that's how you use SE select field and SE label to change the label and substitute a field for another field in a Scriptcase application.